All right. The first piece I'll be playing is Adelita by Francesco Tárrega. This piece is one of his several kind of shorter pieces that he wrote and named after people. And I believe this one is named after his daughter. That's what Mr. Louis told me. Yeah, these pieces aren't his most difficult or elaborate pieces by any stretch, but I kind of think of these short pieces as a like a landmark piece for classical guitarists. Like, if you can play these pieces well, you're doing pretty good. So this is Adelita by Francesco Tárrega. And that was my first piece. The next piece I'll be playing is Endless Trigales by Joaquin Rodrigo. He's also a Spanish composer, and he was blind and didn't actually play the guitar, so many of his compositions are fairly difficult because he's not really thinking about how they should be played physically. Endless Trigales translates to Field of Wheat. It kind of doesn't make any sense because the piece is very intense and kind of sinister, so I kind of think of the fields of wheat as a place of battle more than of leisure. So, Endless Trigales by Joaquin Rodrigo. Thank you. The piece I'll be playing is the oldest piece I'll be playing,
and it's by the Renaissance English lute composer John Dowland, and the piece is Sir John Smith, his alma.
Sir John Smith, he wrote a lot of, he was kind of like a rock star. He wrote a lot of pieces that he would sing and just play his lute to accompany himself, but guitarists and lutists today treasure his instrumental repertoire. I can only surmise that this was written for one of his patrons, Sir John Smith. And I like to imagine that it's the famous Sir John Smith who established the Jamestown settlement. So, and it checks out because they were alive during the exact same time period. So who knows? I put the lute to imitate the capo to imitate the timbral qualities of the lute. Gives it a little bit less bass and resonance.
Thank you.
This next piece I'll be playing is also written for lute, but it's from the Baroque era as opposed to the Renaissance. This piece is written by the famous Bach. All classical musicians are well aware of Bach. And this particular piece is a beginning of one of his lute suites that also happens to be the, I believe, the fifth cello suite. They're the same piece, and Bach just transcribed one for the other instrument. So this is Prelude and Presto by J.S. Bach. Thank you. This is my final piece, and it is Demons by Mikhail Saitchev. I couldn't find too much about Mikhail Saitchev. He teaches guitar, and he's still alive today. He's a Russian composer. But this piece is a good example of program music, which is music that seeks to capture the atmosphere or aesthetic of an emotion or to tell a narrative or story. And this piece in particular is written based off of a poem by the Russian romantic poet and novelist Alexander Pushkin, and I have it written down right here. And the piece is based on this following excerpt. Infinite and brazen in the murky moonlight's play, sun-dried demons flurry and spin akin to leaves in November's day. So this is Demons by Mikhail Saitchev. Thank you.
by you.
For my first piece, I will be playing Dancing E Minor by Jorge Morel. This piece was composed during Morel's visit to England in 1979 to 1980 and has been established as one of his finest recital pieces. Jorge Morel was born in Argentina in 1931 and sadly passed away this year on February.
Thank you.
be playing Etude No. 18 by Matteo Carcassi. Matteo Carcassi was an Italian guitarist who spent much of his life in Paris. Etude No. 18 is one of the 25 melodic progressive studies that were published in 1853. And Etude No. 18 is a line and dancing piece in rapid triplets. Was a Brazilian composer, guitarist, and music teacher who spent most of his life in Rio de Janeiro. Saeia Perguntar has a beautiful melody line of great sensitivity.
Thank you.
For my next piece, I will be playing Capriccio Arbe by Francisco Torrega. Francisco Torrega was a Spanish guitarist. Capriccio Arbe is his most popular piece, and he wrote it while staying in Valencia in 1888. A year later, the piece was printed in Barcelona, becoming his first published composition. Thank you. For my final piece, I will be playing Mazurka Choro by Hitor Villalobos. Mazurka Choro is an enchanting piece that forms part of the Suite Popular Brazilian. The suite is made up of five pieces, and Mazurka Choro is the first in the suite. They were written between 1906 and 1923. Mazurka Choro was dedicated to Maria Teresa Terran, who is the wife of Villalobos' good friend Thomas Terran.
Thank you. My name is Ty Taylor, and today I'll be performing my senior concert. I'm a senior at Weaver Academy. I'll start off my concert by playing Ukrainian folk song by Nikita Koshkin. Then I'll move on to Preludio by Massimo Diego Pulho, followed by Etude 1, 5, and 6 by Leo Brouwer, Brasileirino by Joao Pernambuco, and the intro to Prelude No. 4 by Heitor Villa-Lobos. To start off this, I'll be playing Ukrainian folk song by Nikita Koshkin, a Russian composer and guitarist. He gets most of his inspiration from people like Stravinsky and from genres like classical rock. Next, I'll be playing Preludio by Massimo Diego Pulho, an Argentinian composer who got most of his inspiration from Argentina. He wrote a set of pieces that were named Preludio, Tango, Milonga, Candombe, and Merga. Most of his pieces are very upbeat, rhythmic pieces, the tango being his first piece, the Prelude, is more of a slower, softer piece. Mm-hmm. Next, I'll be playing Etudes 1, 5, and 6 by Leo Brower, a Cuban composer born in Havana. He's a very infamous and well-known composer in the guitar world, creating a set of studies called the Etudes Simples. Next, I'll be playing Brasileirinho by João Pernambuco, a Brazilian composer. Thank you. lastly, I'll be playing the intro to Prelude Number 4 by Villa-Lobos. Thank you all so much for watching my senior concert. Hope you have a good evening or day.